Guys, welcome to our channel. In this video, I will tell you each and everything that you should know about the NEET Counseling 2020, right from the day of declaration result till the acquiring a seat in the medical college. So let's start with the video. The NEET Counseling involves two types of counseling. First one is the All India Quota Counseling and second one is the State Counseling that is carried out by the respective states. So in order to understand this, let me explain something. Suppose there are 100 seats in a medical college, then out of 100, 85%, that's for 85 seats, is reserved for the state. What does it mean? Only the students that belongs to a particular state, say Uttar Pradesh or Madhya Pradesh, they can only acquire this place and not anybody else from any other state like the Karnataka or any other state of the India. Now the remaining 15%, suppose there are 200 seats, then this will be around 170, and if it's 15% of 100 seats is 15 seats, is fixed or reserved for the students of all India. And the students across the India can apply for these 15 seats. So 85 seats out of 100 seats, 85%. Or you can say out of total seats, 85% reserved for the state and the remaining 15% belongs to the All India students. Means the students across the India can apply for these states. So the counseling began in two phases. First one is the All India Counseling, Quota Counseling and State Counseling, and you have to apply separately for each of them. So usually what happens, All India Quota Counseling begins earlier, so you have to check out the MCI website which is given in the link below. You can keep checking the website for updates and should apply for the All India Quota Counseling. Suppose you belong to Uttar Pradesh and want to take a seat in Madhya Pradesh, then in supposing college MGMC, Mahatma Gandhi Memorial College, then you should have to apply for the 15 seats only that are present in that college. Now let me tell you about some state counseling. Now the remaining 85 seats counseling are carried on by the respective states, that is called by the respective state name. Suppose UP NEET Counseling is the name for the state counseling of Uttar Pradesh, and suppose for Bihar, it's Bihar NEET Counseling, and the respective websites are different in which you can check out on the net. Respective websites are available with ease on the internet. So suppose you have to first do the All India Counseling as well as the State Counseling. So you have to apply for the All India Quota Counseling, for which you can apply for all over India, and for the State Counseling you have to apply in which you can get the seats in the respective state only. So the main net thing that you learn from this, that you have to apply separately for the All India Quota Counseling and the State Counseling, which dates will be announced later. Now let's begin. What all are the documents required for getting a seat in a state and a All India Quota Counseling, and what are the fees? So let me start with the fees. In an All India Quota Counseling, suppose I'm living in Uttar Pradesh and I acquired a seat in Madhya Pradesh, so the in that I have to pay a security deposit of 10,000 in case of, so I have to deposit a fees of 10,000 in case of All India Quota Counseling, and for the Uttar Pradesh State Counseling it's around 30,000 security fees. So you have to pay 10,000 in case of All India Quota Counseling and 30,000 in case of the State Counseling of the NEET. Apart from this, I talk about the general category. The price is less, the security amount is less in comparison to the other categories like that of OBC and the remaining category. Apart from this, you have to pay additional 1,000 rupees in each case for the registration charges. So the 30,000 plus 1,000 registration fees, I think it's 2,000 in state, but on an average in different states you can take it out as 1,000, and for the All India Counseling also it is 1,000. Apart from this, you have to pay the net charges or the transaction charges applied for the same. So you have to pay a net of around 11,000 and a net of around 31 to 32,000 in the case of Uttar Pradesh NEET Counseling. So what are the documents required? The first basic documents required from the school, that you should get from the school, are your 10th mark sheet as well as your result card. There are two separate mark sheet in the case of the IAC board. In case of CBSE board, they get only one mark sheet. So you can get the mark sheet from the school, that's from 10th and 12th mark sheet and scorecard or scorecard. Okay, from school you have to get your 10th and 12th mark sheet, and apart from this you have to get your transfer certificate, your migration certificate, and apart from this we have other documents as well, that includes your character certificate, character certificate. So in total around 5 to 6 certificates you need required from that will be provided by school, that 10th 12th mark sheet or scorecard, transfer certificate, migration certificate and the character certificate. Apart from the things that you require from the school, you need your NEET admit card printout, NEET admit card, your rank letter, that's a NEET result page, your rank letter, the admission letter to a particular college when you are given a seat from the counseling. So you need to require NEET admit card, rank letter and admission letter. This letter is provided when you acquire a college through the counseling. When you acquire a college through counseling. Certain documents you have to make when you reach the particular college that is allotted to you after the counseling, that are some affidavits. So, okay, some affidavits you need, that are the first is your gap certificate. Gap certificate is required only when after 12th you took some preparation leave for 1 or 2 years, then you have to get your gap certificate. Then there are certain anti-ragging, parents and students affidavit. Then you have to go get your bond letter. So if I am applying for a college in anywhere in India, I have to get this all documents with myself. These all documents you will get from your the school, NEET admit card, rank letter, admission letter, you have to get it print out. And these all things, that all the documents, all the legal documents you have to get through the lawyer, that will be available at your respective college that is allotted to you. I will be uploading a second video soon about when we can leave a college without the redemption of the fees, or what are the ways in which you can apply for a higher college with good rank. That is, how can you upgrade your college, in the next video. So if you like the video, please hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.